Good morning, ma. So today we are going to be calculate center of gravity for the given this diagram. This diagram is not symmetric about any axis. So here in the problem, he was given the coordinate axis as x-axis. Let us take this is OX axis and this one is OY axis. With reference to the OX axis and OY axis, we need to calculate its center of gravity. So at the same time, before going to calculate the center of gravity, whether the given diagram is symmetric about X axis or Y axis, that is we need to find out. But the given diagram is unsymmetric about both axes. Therefore, we need to calculate both X bar as well as the Y bar with reference to the OX axis as well as OY axis. So before going to calculate the problem, See, the given section is a complex shape. So we need to divide this section into different known shapes. That means by dividing of these shapes, we can get rectangles or triangles or squares. So therefore, here according to this given problem, we are able to cut this shape into number of known shapes such as rectangles. So let us see. See, we are going to be dividing these shapes like this. Say based on my comfort, I am taking these shapes like this. So after that one, take the numbering of these shapes. Let us take this one as 1, and this is as 2, and this one is 3, and this one is 4. See, in the given problem, I am divided these shapes into 4 parts. So for these 4 parts, we are need to calculate its areas as well as the center of gravity with reference to the OX axis as well as OY axis. So let us take first areas. So calculate area of part 1. So area of part 1, that is, let us take A1 is equal to, see, the width as well as the length of these all the rectangles are given. So see, I need to take the first part only. So from here only we need to take. So therefore, this is 20 and this is 10. So total height is 30. So 30 into 10. This is the width. 30 into 10, that is equals to 300. So here all dimensions are in mm. All dimensions are in mm. So 300 mm square, A1. So similarly, area of part 2, that is A2, is equals to, what is the part 2? This one. So here, what are the dimensions? And say this is 20 and this is the 10. So 30, the remaining is, we are going to be having 20. 20 is height and width is 10. This 10, this height is 20. See, total height is 50. So in that, this is 20, this is 10. So therefore, the remaining is 20 mm. So therefore, 20 into 10 is equals to 200 mm square. And what about area of part 3? Area of part 3, A3 is equals to this part. So from here to here, we need to consider. So the total length of this one is 40 and width is 10. So 40 into 10 is equals to 400 mm square. So also area of part 3, sorry, 4, part 4, A4 is equals to, this is the fourth part. So its dimensions are 10 by 10. So 10 into 10 is equals to 100 mm square. So we got areas of part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4. And then go for calculation of X bar and Y bar with references from OX as well as OY. So let us calculate first X bar. See, for X bar. So to calculate X bar, we need to take the reference line as OY. Here, take OY as reference lines. OY as reference line. So by taking of OY as reference line, so first take first part. For first part, center of gravity, CG, center of gravity of part 1 from OY axis. So that is x1 is equal to, see the horizontal distance of this part 1 is 10. So but its center of gravity is 10 by 2. It becomes 10 by 2. That is equals to 5 mm. And then center of gravity of part 2. Part 2 from similarly same OY axis. That is x2 is equals to, this is the part 2. So same horizontally it becomes 10 by 2 same. 10 by 2 that is equals to 5 mm. And then center of gravity of part 3 from same OY axis x3 is equals to, so this is the part 3. So therefore part 3 is starts from here only. So but before that, from OY axis we have distance of 10 mm, so we need to add that first. So 10 plus the remaining total distance of a part 3 along x axis is 40. So it is becomes 40 by 2. Its center of gravity stands at 40 by 2. So, but from OY axis we need to take 10 plus 40 by 2. That is equals to 10 plus 40 by 2 is 20. This equals to 30 mm. So and then center of gravity for part 4. Center of gravity of part 4 from OY axis, from OY axis, so it becomes x4 is equals to, see the part 4 is, see this is the diagram, part 4 starts from this distance itself. So up to here what is the distance from OY axis? See from OY axis part 1 is there as well as part 3 also there. From part 1 it is 10 mm. From part 1 to part 4 we have some distance, so that is nothing but, so actually the total is 40. So but the part 4 starts from here itself, so we need to remove this 10 mm from 40. So therefore 10 plus 30 from here to here we have distance of 30 mm. So x4 is equals to 10 plus 30 plus the remaining distance is 10 by 2. 10 by 2 that is equals to 10 plus 30 plus 10 by 2 5. So that is equals to 45 mm. So therefore this is x1, x2, x3, x4. So after this one, so go for formula calculation of this x bar. So finally x bar is equals to, we know that the formula is a1 x1 plus a2 x2 plus a3 x3 plus a4 x4 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus a4. So by substituting of all the values, a1 is equals to, a1 is 300 into 5 x1 plus a2 is equals to 200, x2 is equals to 5, 200 into 5 plus a3, see a3 is 400, x3 is 30, 400 into 30 plus a4 and x4, a4 is equals to 100, x4 is equals to 45, 100 into 45. 100 into 45 divided by a1 300 plus 200 a2 plus 400 a3 plus 100 a4. So by solving of this value, so by calculating of this x4, x bar is equals to, we are going to get, so if you solve this one, so we are going to get x bar is equals to 19 mm. Once you go through these values, so 300 into 5 300 into 5 plus 200 into, so use brackets, 200 into 5 plus 400 into 30 plus 100 into 45, 19, 3 zeros, divided by, we are going to get 300 plus 200 plus 400 plus 100. So finally we are going to get the total value is, see, as a calculator diet gave us, no? Finally we are going to get 19 mm. This is X bar. So similarly, so for Y bar, so same we got already A1, A2, A3, A4. So but now we need to take Y1, Y2, Y3 from OX axis. So in this case, the careful thing, one thing you need to remember is, see, part 1 is above part 1, part 3, part 4 are above X axis. So therefore, we are going to take directly plus, okay, na? So but whenever you are going to go for Y2 value, so but the Y2, the part 2 is below OX axis. That is, this is along the Y dash, that is negative. So we need to take a minus. Okay. So therefore, for part 2, Y2, in that case, we need to take care. So first one, Y1 is equals to center of gravity for part 1 from OX axis is equals to, so what is the total height is nothing but, so 30, 20 plus 10, 30. So it stands at half of the distance, 30 by 2, it is equals to 15 mm. And Y2 is equals to, it is below the OX axis, for the reference line OX axis, the total distance is 20. So minus, we need to represent, minus 20 by 2 is equals to minus 10 mm. And Y3 is equals to, what about Y3? Y3 is this one. So this is 10 mm high from OX axis. So therefore, simply 10 by 2 is equals to 5 mm. And Y4 is equals to, Y4 is this one. So this is away from OX axis at a distance of 10 mm. So we need to add this 10 mm first and then remaining 10 by 2. So 10 plus 10 by 2. 10 plus 10 by 2. Is equals to 10 plus 5 is equals to 15 mm. That's it. So now Y bar is equals to formula. Y bar is equals to A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 plus A3 Y3 plus A4 Y4 divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. So simply substitute the values. So where A1 is equals to 300 into Y1 is 15 plus A2 is 200 into Y2 is minus 10 plus A3 is 400 into Y3 is equals to 5 plus A4 is 100 into Y4 is 15. Here 15, this is value. So divided by 300 plus 200 plus 400 plus 100. So by getting the value in the calculator, so you are going to get 6 mm from OX axis. So finally this is X bar and Y bar. So therefore CG X bar comma Y bar is equals to 19 mm comma 6 mm. So from where and day? So with from OX as well as OY axis. So X bar is from OY axis, Y bar is from OX axis. So finally, if we want to represent its center of gravity, so let us draw the diagram. See, so like this, the diagram is represented. See, so this is the reference line, OX axis, and this is OY axis. So center of gravity from OX axis is nothing but Y bar. Center of gravity from OY axis is X bar. So X bar is 19 mm. So let us assume up to here, and then Y bar is 6 mm. So 6 mm is, this is the 10 mm totally. So above OX bar is 6 mm. So up, let us take approximately. So it may stands at this point. So this is Y bar, and this distance is going to be considered as X bar. So like this way, we need to represent the X bar as well as Y bar also from this point. Okay, this is the way to calculate the center of gravity. So if you have any doubts, so comment your doubts in the comment section. So in the next class, we will discuss different types of some more problems on the center of gravity only. Thank you.